Namaste everyone and welcome to the new episode of Breaking It Down. Today we are going to discuss the real winners of the Bihar elections. Now as you know that yesterday only the Election Commission of India announced the results of Bihar elections and the NDA has won a considerable victory on RJD and Congress's Mahagathbandhan. And Nitish Kumar is not very interested to continue as a chief minister because he has been reduced as a junior partner in NDA, so on and so forth. But Nitish Kumar is not the real winner of this election. There are three winners of one single election. The first winner is JP Nadda. Jayaprakash Nadda is the national president of Bharatiya Janata Party. He was working as the interim president from June 2019 to January 2020. On 20th January 2020, he was appointed by the Bharatiya Janata Party election method as the national president. And since then, this was Nadda's first major state election, which validated his appointment in a sense. Jayaprakash Nadda had three obstacles. The first obstacle was the COVID pandemic. And this was an obstacle faced by all the parties in the elections. However, BJP is notoriously known as the party with resources. But disposal of these resources in a way that it can win you elections is also very important. And Jayaprakash Nadda really did it. From LED screens to digital rallies, from getting the message across was one of the biggest challenges of this election for all the parties. But BJP performed its standard operating procedures well and did prove the exit polls wrong this time also. The second obstacle in front of Jayaprakash Nadda was its ally itself, that is JDU. Now JDU will be forming the government and Nitish Kumar will be our chief minister was a constant call right from the prime minister to the lowest cadre of the party. But there was always a fear that Nitish Kumar will skip the boats from NDA to Mahagathbandhan again. So BJP's goal was to undermine JDU to such an extent, to reduce their tally to such an extent that they will not be able to skip the boats because of their numbers, because of their lower numbers, the allies in Mahagathbandhan will not be ready, especially Tejaswi Yadav, will not be ready to give Nitish Kumar the CM seat on the numbers which Nitish Kumar has won in the election. And exactly the same thing happened. JDU was reduced to a very, very low tally. And now if even Nitish Kumar thinks to skip the boat and go to the Mahagathbandhan, Tejaswi Yadav will always demand the CM seat for which Nitish Kumar will never agree to. For this task, Jayaprakash Nadda took the help of NDA's ally in the center but not so ally in Bihar, that is LJP, whose chief Ram Vilas Paswanji passed away during the election poll campaigning itself. So this was the second challenge. The third challenge in front of JP Nadda was basically BJP's own leadership in Bihar. BJP has not cultivated its leadership in Bihar prominently for past 20 years. There is Devendra Fadnavis in Maharashtra, Shivraj Singh Chauhan in Madhya Pradesh, Vasundhara Raje in Rajasthan. We don't have a leader, so to say, in Gujarat. Modi was a leader from Gujarat. But then in Bihar, which is the Hindi heartland, which is the stronghold of BJP, BJP has been unable to cultivate any kind of strong leadership. So it was imperative for JP Nadda to win seats without a face. Sushil Kumar Modi is definitely not a face of BJP in Bihar. So the main challenge in front of JP Nadda was to win votes and win seats without having a prominent driving force and face in Bihar. The second hero of this election was no other than Maharashtra's ex-CM Shri Devendra Fadnavis. Now, this is kind of a system of Bharatiya Janata Party to send leaders from other state to some different state and appoint them as Prabhari of the election. This happened with Maharashtra also. In Madhya Pradesh, for the time of changing the government on transition from Kamal Nath to Shivraj Singh Chauhan was done by a Prabhari who was not originally from Maharashtra, from Madhya Pradesh. He was from Maharashtra, that is Sri Vinay Sahasrabuddhe ji. So Devendra Fadnavis did manage to get 100 plus seats in Maharashtra, but then the central leadership of BJP was like, okay, this was your home turf. Now if you want a leverage against the central leadership and if you have to prove that you are a pan-India leader, prove your mantle in Bihar. And Devendra Fadnavis, who was unknown to Bihar's complex caste and religious demography as well as the nuanced politics there, where LJP was fighting against JDU but not BJP, JDU was not happy with BJP, BJP was not happy with JDU but was kind of comforting with LJP. So this was a complex political situation. Devendra Fadnavis was heavily working in Maharashtra, assessing the flood and the pandemic situation. He managed to do both very nicely, and the results, and I'm saying he managed to do both nicely because the results are out, and BJP managed to get a very good tally in Bihar. Now, Devendra Fadnavis' job was more difficult because he was a Neta from Maharashtra. Bihar and Maharashtra do not have the best of interconnectedness, where Maharashtra is known for parties who were hostile towards North Indians, especially people from UP and Bihar. So Devendra Fadnavis had to cultivate relationship with the leaders of Bihar. He had to cultivate a relationship with the people of Bihar, work there on the ground facing the pandemic situation. This is very important. He was doing live rallies. He was working on the ground. He was coming to and fro. Later he was diagnosed with COVID pandemic, COVID, and then he took a rest in St. George Hospital. But that is a different story. So the second challenge in front of Devendra Fadnavis was to understand Bihar in such a short time. He was appointed as Bihar's Prabhari just on 30th November 2020. So he had hardly 1 month to understand Bihar, to study Bihar's demography, and then select the candidates, appoint the candidates, plan its campaign and everything. Basically, in Hindi or in BJP's organizational language, they call it Sarve Sarva. Is basically someone who handles almost everything. So he had 1 month to prove to the central leadership that he has the mantle to win seats not only in Maharashtra but also in Bihar. The third winner in this election is Tejaswi Surya. He is a member of parliament from Bengaluru South constituency, and he has been a firebrand youth icon of Hindutva for BJP and for the youth who are the core voters of BJP. But again, you have to understand and observe the pattern of how every party functions and chooses its leaders. For some parties, you have to have a surname. And for some parties, you have to work in different conditions. Now, I will give you a different circumstance and a different, completely different situation here. West Bengal is a long drawn battle for BJP. BJP is making inroads in West Bengal, but even the central leadership knows that BJP will have to fight from Gram Panchayat to the state assembly to the central elections in West Bengal for next 10 to 15 years. Didi will not be defeated by a single election and a single round of some local municipal corporations and stuff like that. So it's a long drawn battle. Modi, Shah might and might not be there after 10-15 years, completely functional as they are now today. So they have to cultivate a kind of leadership here. BJP obviously chose Tejaswi Surya because he is the firebrand icon of Hindutva, as I had mentioned earlier. So now, if Tejaswi Surya failed, again he would be limited to his duties and job as the Yuva Morcha leader of BJP, and he is one of the rare South Indians who was appointed as the Yuva Morcha leader. But then he was tested in West Bengal and Bihar that can a South Indian leader be accepted in North India's Hindi core heartland who has complete different equations and different caste language. And language was one of the barrier. If you have seen the speeches of Tejasvi Surya, he was speaking in absolutely fluent Hindi. Now there are some times where he took the help of English, but that's fine. But he did manage to speak in Hindi. So this image of a South Indian leader had to be changed, and I think Bihar elections was a perfect time for Tejasvi Surya, who backed this opportunity and again emerged as one of the victorious winners of Bihar elections. That's my analysis for who was the real winner of Bihar elections. We'll meet in the next video of Breaking It Down. Till then, stay tuned, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and share this with your friends who have interest in politics, and share this with people who have interest in politics as much as you can. We'll meet next time. Take care of yourself. These are hard times. Jai Hind,